And hello everyone, it is Peter Sam, the NarrowGauge Engine here, and we're beginning a new series of top 10 videos across the channel. And what better one to start with than the worst Brenner episodes of all time. The Brenner era was really a mixed bag in terms of quality. Sometimes we'd have episodes that felt like they belong in the classic era, and sometimes we have ones that felt more like they belong in season 15. And it's these ones we'll be looking at today. Just before we start, I'd like to mention that my opinions are subject to change, so some of the orderings of episodes switch around from time to time. An example I can give is, despite me thinking that both of these episodes are 5 out of 5s, in terms of hit era quality anyway, I now believe that Respect for Gordon is better than Thomas and the New Engine. Anyway, we're not here to talk about 5 out of 5s, unfortunately, today. We're here to look at the duds, starting with... Number 10, Samson Sent for Scrap. I think we'll start off with a positive here. I like how the episode begins with Scruff showing an aspect of his work that we never got to see before. It's a nice little detail that does a lot for him and the episode as a whole in my opinion, but it ended up on this list for a reason and it's called Samson. He's so obnoxious it's hard to root for him, and what's more, he's quite cocky too, making him just flat out unlikable. He thinks the back of the steamworks carries on out to the main line despite having seen that it doesn't 10 seconds prior. The things he believes are scrap to be put in the trucks look brand new. Like, how much of an idiot do you have to be to think a shiny red bicycle looks like scrap? The end of this episode isn't much better either, with Scruff returning seemingly out of nowhere, which begs the question, couldn't Sir Topham just have waited for Scruff to be fixed instead of palming his jobs off onto Samson? That's such a strange course of action to take. Then after Sir Topham tells Samson off, they all start laughing for one reason or another, and then the episode just decides to end on that note. It just ruins the mood and ultimately leaves you feeling confused. This episode is not that good. Not many of the Samson ones are, unfortunately, and that is a true shame. Number 9, Pouty James. I think the first line really summarises some of what I have to say when the narrator says James is always showing off. The lack of understanding this guy has for how his bad behaviour will culminate into the consequences he gets is so annoying. Is it any wonder you get your coaches taken away when you fail to act upon instructions told to you by the Fat Controller? Speaking of, he's a bit weird too. His fatherly role and his cartoony attitude have been dialed up way too much, and it just makes every scene he's in feel uncomfortable and off-putting. He calls James a young steam engine despite being one of the longest serving on the railway. That's so strange. And then on top of all that, we have to deal with these silly faces that the characters make, and it is just way too much to handle. Although despite the low points being worse than Samson Sent for Scrap, there are more things I can appreciate about this one. There's a nice tracking shot montage of James doing work, and him disappointing some brat children is quite funny too. I also like that Stanley has a line for once, and the resolution is decent. All of that is why I decided to put it at number 9 on my list. Number 8, Calm Down Caitlin. God, these are only getting worse, aren't they? It's only just sinking in now that that's the point of the list, but it doesn't make it any more enjoyable for me. Let's start at the start. I don't get the point of having Caitlin break down and for the bridge being closed for repairs. We could have just had the latter and used that extra time for more semi-amusing moments at Tibner Sheds, which were the only enjoyable parts of the episode. The episode's namesake is so annoying too, as she also blatantly disregards the Fat Controller's warnings. The Fat Controller himself also doesn't get off scot-free once again because he blatantly tells Caitlin the moral of the episode right at the start, which means Caitlin actively needs to be an absolute unlikable moron for the story to progress in any way whatsoever. And to top it all off, the ending isn't even that good either. This episode is a train crash that I can't look away from in the vain hope that Caitlin ends up involved in it. Number 7, No Help At All. This isn't the only Bill, Ben, and Timothy episode to end up on this list, so I'm going to keep this one fairly concise, as a lot of what I have to say here can also be said for the other episode, which I think is far, far worse. The manipulative sides of Bill and Ben are in full swing here, treating Timothy like an object and disposing him like a piece of toilet paper whenever they feel like he's getting in the way. That is just downright toxic. What's more, it doesn't even feel like they learn anything here. Sir Topham does give them a telling off, but that is directly countered by the fact that Timothy, Salty, and Porter come to help. So in the end, Bill and Ben get what they want, and poor Timothy will continue to be tormented until the end of time. At least Timothy has a break from the twins in this one, with the Down by the Docks montage actually giving both of our minds a rest. Number 6, Over the Hill. This episode is the second part of the Glynn duology, with the first part being the Christmas coffee pot. We get a flashback for it in this episode, which I don't really think is needed for episodes that come as a pair. Grandpuff and Sleeping Beauty had a similar problem back in season 4, but at least that had charming characters, fun lore, and a thrilling rescue operation. All that this episode has is a character regression for Steven, who feels second best after Sir Robert Norrenby ignores him for 2 minutes, and Glynn going from rejecting the notion of a race to participating within seconds. It just feels so random and that the story was put into consideration more than the characters themselves. There's a cool Eye of the Tiger gag in there and some nice real-world historical references, but the two main characters seem to have regressed into this midlife crisis stage that they should definitely both be over by now. I think a better concept for this episode would be to have Glynn warn Steven about a danger to the castle, with Steven brushing it off as something that doesn't need fixing because he's been there numerous times and nothing's happened, only then for something bad to happen. Maybe a warped section of track, or a tree that seems in danger of falling on the line. Whatever it might be, it'd be better than what we ended up getting. Just before we carry on, I'd like to take the time to list a few honourable mentions that didn't quite make it onto the list. I'm doing this segment here as a nice little break before I carry on, so you can have a breather if you aren't all that interested in episodes that were bad, but not bad enough. These ones couldn't even do that job right. Anyway, firstly, I'd like to mention Runaway Engine from season 21, the only episode from that season that was up for consideration. Once again, we have to bear witness to Steven's childish behaviour, which is absolutely awful for me. He is my favourite CGI series character, and to see him get regressed to this just hurts my soul. The only reason I didn't add it on was because I thought that, all things considered, the episode we just spoke about was far worse, and I didn't want to repeat myself too many times in this video. That reasoning is also the same for why I didn't include Timothy and the Rainbow Truck on the list. I just can't speak about Bill and Ben that much without my head deflating to the size of a chestnut. Finally, Scruff's Makeover was just one of the ones that was definitely really close to being on the list. However, it just didn't quite tick the boxes for what I consider to be some of the worst things an episode can do. Have an unlikable protagonist, have the Fat Controller ruin the episode in one way or another, and have some level of character regression. This episode didn't really do any of these things, since Scruff didn't really have much of a character. The Fat Controller is a functioning human with working brain cells again, and Scruff himself isn't all that annoying. Wanting to protect his paintwork is a bit forgivable, considering he's not really been cleaned like that before. Finding something new you enjoy and latching onto that and protecting it isn't really on the same par as manipulation or brashish behaviour, is it? Well, with all that out the way, time to continue with the top 5, the worst offenders in the Brenner era, and no better place to start than with... Number 5, Steamy Stafford. What does this episode do well? I'm honestly sat here thinking this and not one single thing is popping into my head. I suppose the resolution could have been worse, but then again, it's nothing brilliant. Pretty much everything in this episode stinks. Stafford seems like a very competent engine and yet gets insecure over a bunch of children being disappointed with the fact that he doesn't make noise. Stafford's solution to this problem is making engine noises with his mouth, like he is one of those 5-year-olds from earlier. Then when those same 5-year-olds see him again, they cheer and wave, even though they can definitely tell he's making those noises with his mouth. You're not fooling anyone here, mate, and I don't get how those children aren't judging him for acting like a toddler. Not only is it a stupid solution to the problem, I feel this episode shouldn't have been given to Stafford because he just doesn't seem like that type of character. With the obvious narrative changes to account for the fact they aren't electric, I feel there are plenty more childlike characters that would benefit so much more from this. Charlie, Paxton, hell, even I'd be better suited for the role. With all that said, there's still worse out there, and we're going to talk about them now. Number 4, Henry Spots Trouble. In my notes for this episode, I wrote down, Henry is just the worst, and that is absolutely the case for this one. He's so worrisome and timid that it's actually difficult to root for him. It's a case of the writers focusing too much on comedy and too little on likability. As much as Henry's screaming might annoy us, a child might find that funny, and don't even get me started on Sir Topham Hatt. Although, he was a little bit comical. Once again, I have to bring him up because his character shift from being mad at Henry for reversing down the line and smiling as he gets out of Winston explaining the situation is rather jarring. Season 2 or Season 4 Sir Topham Hatt would have beaten him with a hammer. The idea of this whole situation even occurring in the first place is stupid too, because Henry's an old engine, the narrator even says so. So whilst it could happen, I find it very unlikely that he's never heard of or even seen chickenpox before this point. All in all, this episode just has Henry leaping logic so much that it feels almost forced, and he's such a baby that it's actually infuriating. Number 3, No Steam Without Coal. This is the other Bill and Ben episode I detest that I mentioned previously. They are definitely worse to Timothy in this episode than with no help at all, due to them pointing out how he's an oil-burning engine, and making him feel ashamed because of that. It's a hard-hitting plot that I imagine a lot of people out there can relate to, which is why it's awful that Bill and Ben don't truly get punished for their actions. What's more, Timothy just helps them without giving them some kind of stern word or mocking them in any capacity. If I was in his shoes, I'd be making them suffer for just a little bit. But I think what truly is the worst part of this entire episode is how the narrator calls Bill and Ben's bullying jokes. It really isn't. It happens in future episodes, and there have most likely been previous instances too, and what they do isn't even funny. They just point out how Timothy's different and belittling for it. That is straight up discriminatory, and the fact that the writer of this episode, Davey Moore, thought that it was okay to label it as a joke is actually kind of harmful now that I think about it. It invalidates the hurt the Timothys in these situations feel by brushing Bill and Ben's actions off as funny or lighthearted. I'm seriously shocked that Moore's script was not only approved, but made into a fully fledged episode. At least the beginning's not all that bad, I suppose, though. There's that. Number 2, The Phantom Express. I've never seen an episode that has such a disregard for characters' personalities like this one. Firstly, Percy acts like a timid child all throughout, and it makes me so annoyed with the writers for characterising him in this rather uncharacteristic way. Especially when you've already turned Henry into an everything-phobe, and Toby's not that much better. They easily could have taken the lead role, and whilst it wouldn't have been much more bearable, at least Percy would have been spared the humiliation. Then there's James. I genuinely think this is him at his worst. At least when he's obsessing over his paint, he's not actively being vicious, but here, he is definitely acting in that way. And there's no real reason behind it. Like, what is his motive right at the beginning of the episode? Further on, it's explained that he keeps being horrible due to Percy and Stephen not believing him, but what is he gaining from doing this to begin with? It's not even a good ghost story, it's literally the most boring thing you could come up with. Later on in the episode, James begins believing the story he made up, which is a plot device used in other episodes in this era. It makes zero sense, as if you're the one that made the story up, you'd know it wasn't real. And James being the natural cynic he is, surely he'd focus on finding a rational explanation rather than letting everything get to him. Then at the end of the episode, James becomes instantly apologetic, and I don't get why. Sure, he found his friend under a drawbridge and presumably a little bit damaged, but this isn't a big crash that resulted in major consequences. They literally just slid down a muddy embankment. For a previously malicious and cruel character just a few minutes before, he really flipped to apologising for no real reason. It's such an odd character shift. There's a lot more I could mention, but I fear the video may become too long as a result of that, so I think we should just get to the worst episode of the entire Brenner era. Number 1, Three Steam Engines Gruff. You've probably noticed by now that very unlikable characters and out-of-character episodes made up almost the entirety of the list, and this episode has those elements in bagfuls. When the only thing I can praise it on is its Trevor cameo, you know there's some serious stuff wrong with this one. Firstly, I don't think I need to mention how annoying the characters are, but it's such a big part of the episode that I can't really ignore it. Toby's so timid he becomes afraid of trees, and Percy's not much better. At least Thomas is bearable, but I'm not about to praise this episode for doing the bare minimum. What we also get a lot of here is direct references to the Three Billy Goats Gruff, which this episode was based on. I feel like this was a bad move because as a result, everything feels so contrived and forced, especially Percy's line where he tells Thomas he must get rid of the troll as he is the third engine to cross the Watermill Bridge. It's actually so ridiculous, and even what nice tension was being built up by the music and cinematography as Thomas is crossing the bridge is ruined by Annie and Clarabelle spoiling the whole story and revealing they were all frightened by a cow. What a terrible ending to a terrible episode. So that's my list. Let me know yours in the comments below, and I'm surprised that an Andrew Brenner episode got the number one spot. It's like he was actively trying to make a bad episode with that one. Maybe he was, who knows. But until we do, I've been Peter Sam, you've been you, and if you want more, please leave a like, a comment, and drop a vote in the next community poll to tell me which video you'd like to see next. Bye-bye.